All right, excuse our beautiful mess around here. We are in the throes of trying to get this place sold so that we can move to our new location on 4 acres. But for right now, what we're doing is we're talking about something you guys asked me to do last week on Manic Mechanic, and that is working on how to get the horns running in your classic Ford. Nothing worse than having somebody pull out in front of you in your classic car, and the only thing you can show them is the finger. Not that finger, though. So what we're going to do today is we're going to try to get the horns on the 64 Falcon running. But after the break, first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about checking out the horns to make sure they honk and beep and make racket.
Restoration of a classic Ford is a journey of discovery. Let Autocrafters help you with yours. We offer quality parts for Falcon, Fairlane, F-Series, Galaxy, Maverick, and Pinto. Contact us today.
First things first, spend a little money with the guys at Autocrafters to get a shop manual for your particular Ford that you are working on. It is a boon for everything on the car, but in this particular instance, what we're working on today with the horns, it is a great thing to have the original wiring diagram if you are lucky enough to not have had someone butcher the crap out of your wiring harness on the car. Autocrafters will set you up with a nice one, and you'll be good to go. I will say this, you can find wiring diagrams online, but my problem is that anymore within the last, say, 5 years, I've seen a slow creep of other websites listing wiring diagrams, and they're basically pulling them off of other people's sites, putting them on their own, and then charging you or asking for information from you to get you to do whatever they want you to do to be able to get your wiring harness diagram. I wouldn't do it. There's a couple of .coms that are good. Average Joe Restorations has a good one. I'll put a link to his for the Mustang down here because he does almost all the Mustang's diagrams. There's another one that I'll put a link below me. I can't remember it right now, but he also has the stuff for the Falcon. But I will say this, most of the ones that are .ca, .it, places like that, they're just trying to get your money or your information off your computer. I wouldn't trust them and I wouldn't do it. The two that I'm going to give you are the two best ones that I know of for those two cars. I really honestly haven't found a good one for Fairlane, so you're kind of stuck there. But what I'm going to move on to now is we're going to test the horns on this thing to make sure that they actually work first, and we're going to move ourselves through the harness that way through the rest of the episode, so away we go. All right, so now I've got my setup ready to go. I've hooked up a negative wire, test lead wire, on here going from the battery to the grounding point on the horn itself. Usually these horns ground to the chassis. Yours may vary a little bit, but most everything I've ever seen grounds to the chassis. And I've got a green wire here going from the positive side of the battery, and I'm going to use it on the other end of it to test my horn's function. That one works. Now, the problem is a lot of times, especially on these early cars where the battery is right over the top of the horn, on the early Falcons, it's an issue. Because I see most of the time those horns are the ones that don't function well. I am not going to pull it out. I'm going to do the other way of doing it, just leaving it in position and taking my test lead down there and trying to make the horn work where it sits right now. I've already unplugged it. Somewhere down in the dark reaches of this cart. Now you can hear that it's trying to work, so what I may do is pull the horn out, because sometimes you get kind of medieval with them and tap on them a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it out and see what we get when we do that. All right, we have one working horn and one non-working horn, and the one that's not working, but there's a couple things you can do to try to make it work. You can whack on it with a hammer lightly. Around the bell, and hopefully that will make that sing out a little bit. I don't think we're going to have any luck on that. These are supposedly rebuildable. This little nut right here controls the tone that comes off the horn, because you have a points system that ties this to this. That vibrates this and makes the horn noise. But this is real finicky about position. I don't even know if we can get this one to work. I'm going to go ahead and ground to the chassis of the horn, and I'm going to see what I get. You hear that? You get a little bit of a tick out of it, but when I mess with the center point here, it doesn't change anything. So I feel like we probably have one that's just done in. I know that some of you guys out there will probably know how to rebuild this thing or how to make it work. But I'm just gonna call time of death on this one and get another horn. Okay, so we now have established we have half of our horn system working. And so what I'm gonna talk about now is I'm gonna talk about making sure you have 12 volts from your battery side over to your relay to make sure that that side of it's in good working order. And this is on an old car. I mean, a lot of times guys will say, well, why are you doing all this? Well, you may have a wire break between there and here. Trust me, over the years, many, many terrible and awful things happen to these classic cars. So there could be a misconnect between here and the relay. This is your hot lead coming off the battery right here. This is a yellow wire coming straight in. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my meter on here and see if we get 12 volts-ish with it grounded. We're at 12.53, so I know I have volts coming to this piece. Now you'll see that I have all kind of green wire and stuff in here. Right now, we are nowhere near complete on this car. This wiring harness is probably even going to completely out. We'll be putting in a wiring harness, most likely from our friends over at American Auto Wire, to show how that goes in these classic Fords. All right, so we got that, and we know that we have 12 volts to the power wire on the relay. So now we're going to check the relay itself to make sure it's functioning. And I'm going to do a hot test with it. It's not going to be a cold test. I prefer to do it with the same kind of stress load it would see if it was in operation. What I've done is I have grounded the actual strap that mounts the relay to a ground point on the chassis, just like it would be if it was in the car. This has to be grounded in order for the relay to work because that is actually your ground. I have my power lead hooked up on this green wire going down to the positive side of the battery. That's the power side right there. I have the white. This is hooked up to what the blue and yellow wire would be, which is going to be your horn button function. This green lead is going out to my voltmeter here so that I can see if I'm getting 12 volts to the horns because they do require 12 volts. They are a very high amp draw item. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to blow my horn by going in and grounding this out, which is what happens in the system. And you'll hear we've got 12.43 volts, which is about what we had over there. We're dropping a little bit of voltage because of the resistance in this. That lets you know that the relay is functioning fine. I'm not going to replace it because it ain't broke. Now what we're going to do is we're going to do a continuity check from the relay harness at the relay into the actual horn button on the column. I don't want to test it at the horn itself. I want to actually test it at the button on the turn signal stalk, because you'll then know that everything between there and the outside of the car is copacetic wiring wise. I have set my meter to tone so that I can know whether or not I've got continuity between the relay up in the front in the engine bay and my horn right here. Now, what I will say before I do this test out is always make sure that all the wires are plugged up. On an original Ford harness assembly, there is a yellow connector on the blue with yellow wire on the chassis side and a yellow connector with the blue and yellow wire on the turn signal assembly side. You always want to make sure that those are hooked up. Ford always went with a female connector on the chassis side, which is the hot side, and on the cold side, they used male connectors because you're not worried about that bullet touching anything and arcing on the chassis and causing a fire. That's why that was done. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do my test to see if I've got tone at the switch. So we have good continuity throughout the system. So we know now that we have good wiring from there to the front, and we have good wiring from the relay to the battery, and we have a good relay, and we have one good horn. The other problem you can possibly have is on the horn side. I'm going to reassemble the horn assembly and see if we get continuity when I actually quote-unquote blow the horn. Reassembly off camera. Okay, now I have gone in and put the wheel on here and got nothing at the button on the wheel itself. You'll see that when I go back for final. And all I'm doing is pulling the spring apart a little bit more so it's completely stretched out. And that way I've got good tension on that copper wire and I'll know that it's at the maximum length it can be. I'm gonna do that to this one as well, just to be sure, because I don't wanna be taking the wheel off and on and off and on. But I'm just gonna stretch the spring a little bit to make sure everything's good and tight. 9 chances out of 10, if you're having a problem with one of these, it's probably gonna be the contacts on here have just been depressed for so long. They're very sad. They've just been depressed. I don't know where that came from. And they've been depressed for so long in here that the spring has lost some of its tension. And so they're not gonna be as deep as they should be. That one's sticking pretty proud now. I'll put the wheel back on again and see what I get. And hopefully I'll have continuity between this button and the other button on the horn ring. If that has continuity there, then I put the horn ring on itself and check for continuity across the horn ring. Away we go. All right, we ran into a problem. We could not get continuity between this button and the backside of the horn ring. There was an issue there and we didn't know what it was. All that stuff is disassembled, so we took the back horn ring piece off with the 3 Phillips head screws and found out that there was some debris on the bottom side of the hole for this button, which is supposed to go all the way down to the plate. And it was keeping the horn from blowing because of this. So now when I go and do my continuity check between here and the rest of the system, I don't know if you can hear that, but we've got continuity now. So now I'm gonna put the horn ring on. Hopefully this will give us a contact situation that's a good one. Sometimes you can have problems with these horn rings not wanting to play nicely with others. We're gonna try to get this thing hooked up here and then do another final continuity check whenever we blow the horn. I have a horn. Yay. All right, that should be our horn system. Now, next we're gonna be coming back with turn signal switch install on this thing, and we'll get all that hooked up. That's gonna be a real nightmare because every bit of connection, except for putting it into the top of this thing, is way down yonder on the column. A lot of fun. Do me a favor though, go out and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you don't get subscribed up, guess what? You're not gonna know anything about what we do on a weekly basis around here. We have Autorestomod and we also have Manic Mechanic that you're seeing today. Both of those channels are running videos every week, even while we're in the throes of getting my mom and dad's house ready for sale. And brother, that sucker is even more work than a classic car. Also, check out our Patreon account at our $10 a month level. You get monthly meetings with me on Zoom. And what that means is you and I and other people sit down and chit-chat about our cars. We do tech questions, Q&A with you guys. It is a lot of fun. I really enjoy those meetings, and I enjoy getting to meet you guys. $10 a month also helps us around here with some of our costing and some of the things that we have to do on a daily basis, like feed the kids that help with the cameras. With all that said, do me a favor, folks. Love on each other, treat each other nice, have a great week, and we'll see you on down the road.